Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I am coming with a new video with a new topic. Don't think that this circuit I already see in your video, so I have no need to see this. But one more thing, due to some problem I cannot give you more video in last 2 months, but I am really sorry for that. All you know, that is called snubber circuit, all you know, or clamp circuit. But I am not telling anything about this snubber circuit. But in my lab, when I do this, I get some problem. If you also, please comment me in my comment box. But today I also replace this circuit some other way that is easier and easy to calculate, and you can do this easily. I also tell you how can you winding your transformer. I can share my experience. Now first point is, never grip your wire with beyond hand. You must use some cloth, that is old cotton cloth or cotton gloves, because in our hand some salt are there, so transformer working not properly, and you cannot get better result for long time. So you do not do this, mind it. First point. Second point is, never use any adhesive tape on your winding. Never use. Same reason, there is also salt, so you don't do this. But in the market, in everywhere over the world, I see all they are use adhesive tape in the winding, but I really hate this. You can use 3 mm, 2 mm polymer sheet. You can get it in the market, so it is easy and better performance can you get from this. Never use any other adhesive or tape in your winding. Key point you have to remember. I will show you how can you winding this transformer with the right way. Suppose if you want, I want to make a 40 kilo volt transformer, I want to make a 75 kilo transformer. If you design a Tesla transformer, suppose you want to design, you want to make a Tesla charger which is really used in battery charger, in that case you have to need high voltage, low ampere. In that transformer, if you use adhesive tape, you cannot get better result. It will be damaged shortly. So you never use this adhesive tape. That is not our point today. I want to show you how to release this circuit from your SMPS. Just hold on. Look at this. That is a full SMPS circuit. Look at this. There is no snubber circuit. Absolutely there is no snubber circuit. Now I going to show you. Look at this transformer. Look, that is your primary winding. Absolutely that is your primary winding. Supply voltage generate here, there is a 220 AC in. there is a bridge, there is a 1 watt 22 ohms resistance, there is a fuse. You can use it in line or neutral, no problem at all. That is the varistor which is protect your spike from the outside of this AC. After that, filter this, all you know that. After that, you put the DC supply in the primary winding of this transformer. That is a flyback, that is a flyback part which is control the SMPS. You see this, that is a signal generator IC or chopper IC, whatever it is. So many name are there, so I don't go to for this. Just see this transformer, that is the important part of this video. Here is a secondary winding 1, secondary winding 2 and secondary winding 3. It's called bifilar coil. That is a bifilar coil. Nikola Tesla, I think you know this name. Nikola Tesla patented this coil but not invent this. Don't forget this. You can go to Wikipedia and check it. Nikola Tesla patented this coil, but I use here this coil like as a snubber circuit. See this, when your power come here and go to this IC, goes to this IC, after that goes to drain and goes to ground. So when this IC is active mode, this IC in active mode, then the drain and source goes to short and power goes through this coil. I think you understand that. So in that time, magnetic field developed in this core. Magnetic field developed in this core. When this IC goes to off, that means total charge through these three coils goes to secondary. At this time, you get some feedback from outside of this, that is your feedback circuit, you know, and control the frequency level, that means PWM, and some spike also generate, you know that. But snubber circuit control this pulse and protect your SMPS primary, secondary winding, primary winding, MOSFET, transistor or IGBT, whatever it is. But in this coil can also do same thing like as a snubber. When pulse generate in this coil and this coil and this coil, both are same pulse will be generated in this coil, but high voltage through this diode to supply like as a snubber circuit. Please hold. This snubber circuit also do same thing. When pulse generate high frequency, when high frequency pulse generate in this transformer, so there is so many noise in the output of this transformer. So snubber or clamp circuit do this, control this high pulse or noise. But when you use this coil, absolutely this coil do same thing through this diode, that is a high frequency diode. Don't forget this. Each and every diode should be high frequency, I mean Schottky diode. Don't forget this. And also some coil are there for filter, that is your output. I cannot tell anything about this because I tell everything in my last video or last 2-3 videos. Or buffer circuit, snubber circuit analysis, SNPS analysis, I can tell everything. So I cannot go much more from this circuit. You know that that is a filter diode, that is also a Schottky diode. That is the point of this video. Hope you like this. If you do this, please like it, share it, and subscribe my channel, please. Thank you.